Buzzer TV presents vintage game shows on Amazon.
Play it cozy, play it cute, play it right, and win the loot on Card Sharks! And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry!
Thank you very much, thank you. Play it cute? Welcome to Card Sharks! We're in the middle of an exciting match, the second game of the match to be exact, so let's open the board and get to the cards! That is an ad, if you will. Load in the cards, and you can see we have a game in progress with these card sharks. Hello, Renee Lackey, our champion. Hi, Renee. Nice to see you again.
Oh, nice to be here.
You've won $3,500
yes.
so far in cold, good old cash.
Yes.
Won't you tell us a little more about yourself?
Well, I'm from Honolulu, and I'm traveling now, working on a book about travel. And this has enabled me to do a little more traveling.
That's right. How far have we gotten you now with the other $3,500?
Well, I was on my way to Costa Rica. Now I think I'm going to get a little further, maybe down to South America.
Terrific. Well, I hope you can get back, Renee. It's nice to have you back here with us. And this is our challenger, Terry Huffman. Hi, Terry.
How are you?
Once again, would you tell us about yourself? I'm fine. How are you?
I'm fine. Well, as I told you on the last show, I'm recently graduated from the University of Hawaii, where I attended on a basketball scholarship. I'm working part-time, I will be going back to school next semester, and I'm single.
You must be a very good basketball player. Ladies like that. Being single had nothing to do with being a basketball player, but because my spies told me you had a couple of offers, right, when you got out?
Well, right after I graduated, I had an offer to play pro ball in Europe, but I'm more interested in furthering my education, so I turned it down.
Good. Where would you have been asked to play? In Italy? I heard it's fun over there, too.
Maybe I'll get there someday.
Good. Good luck to both of you. Each player has their own deck of 52 playing cards, shuffled and cut before we go on the air. Renee, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red cards. Challenger Terry plays the lower cards, the blue cards. And the object of the game is to work your way across the board, predicting whether each of these cards is higher or lower than the one that precedes it. You can see Renee needs just two cards. Terry has to turn over a base card and four cards. And in our best 2 out of 3 match, Renee leads 1-0. The winner of the match goes on to the money cards. To get up there, you have to first answer a high-low toss-up question. Renee, the question goes to you as we left off. We asked 100 Playboy bunnies, would you be willing to pose nude for a Playboy centerfold? How many bunnies said they would?
Well, I've read Playboy a number of times, and it seems that I've read the little biographies of the centerfolds, and they have been bunnies at one time. I would say 75.
75 out of 100 Playboy bunnies said yes, they'd be willing to pose for a Playboy centerfold, Jerry. Higher or lower?
Well, Jim, I think I tend to agree with her, but I don't think quite as many would really go for it. I'm just going to say lower.
Lower than that. It is lower, Terry. You go to the board first. If not, it'll be Renee. The actual number of bunnies who said they would pose for a nude centerfold is 45. It's lower, Terry. Terry, we'll take a look at your base card, and you start with a king.
I like that.
Card.
Okay, Jim, we'll go lower.
Lower than a king. It is a 7. Remember, you can freeze at any time or continue.
Gotta freeze.
You'll freeze it right there. And we move the freeze bar over. Can't take those cards away from you. Question to you, Terry. We asked 100 inmates currently serving time in a California prison, have you ever been in prison before this? How many inmates said yes, they had been in prison before?
I've read quite a bit about inmates and correctional systems, and a good percentage do go back. I'll say about 70. 70, yes.
70 out of 100 inmates have been in prison before, Renee.
I agree with Terry, but I think that the percentage would be a little lower, so I'd say fewer. Lower.
Lower than that.
Mm-hmm.
The actual number of prisoners who had been in prison before is 51. It's lower, Renee. That's a surprise. I thought it might be higher than that. Renee, you have the 6 as your base card, but you won the high-low toss-up. You have the right to change it if you'd like.
I'm a little nervous about the 6. I'd like to change it, please.
Here's the next card off the top of your deck. You must play this one. It is a 7. Ooh, not a good change. Call this card, Renee.
I'll go with the odds and go higher, please, Jim.
Higher than a 7. No, it's a 5. It's not higher. You lose that card, and that means Terry gets a chance to play off this 7, which he cannot change. What's this card, Terry?
I'll go with the same odds she went and hope mine's right. Higher, please.
Higher than a 7. And no, you're not right either. It's a 4. Janice will fill in the spaces there, and we go to the fourth and final question. It is sudden death. Someone has to win on this play of the cards, and this question decides control of the board. Renee, we asked 100 people in a California studio audience, do you think that smoking cigarettes should be prohibited by law? How many said yes?
I think an awful lot of people don't go for smoking, but I don't think they'd say it should be prohibited by law. I'd say 30.
30 say yes, cigarette smoking should be prohibited. Perry, higher or lower?
I think people have a tendency to be a little more conscious towards the law, and that would be, you know, against somebody's rights. I'll say lower.
You say lower than that. The actual number of brilliant and intelligent people who agree with me and say smoking should be prohibited is 32. It's not lower, Renee. Renee, you've got control. Now listen carefully. Sudden death, you have a 7. You have the right to change that if you'd like. And try to turn these two cards over. But if you make a mistake, Terry wins the game. However, you can force Terry to play off the 7 and try to turn these three over. If he makes a mistake, then you win the game. Your decision. You want to play it yourself for 2 or pass it to Terry and have him play it for 3?
I'm going to pass it to Terry.
All right. Terry, this is it. Renee leads 1-0, so you've got to turn them all over correctly to stay in the match. Call this one.
This is a one-shot deal. Let's go up.
Higher than a 7. No, it's not higher. Renee wins the game and the match. Congratulations. Congratulations. Terry, those cards did not like you.
I had a great time anyway, Jim.
Thank you. That's nice. We have some nice party gifts for you, too, Terry.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming. Good luck in your studies. Renee, come on down here. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
And now the fun part that you like.
That's what I like.
The money cards, where she can win thousands, coming up right after this commercial message. And we're back with our champion, Renee Lackey, who's now won $3,600. You got a good group out here rooting you on, too. Does that help?
Yes, definitely. I've listened to their remarks.
Oh, they've helped you a lot, huh? Yes. Well, let's see if they can root you home now as we open the board and get to the money cards. Come on up here, Renee. $200 you just won in the match. Yours to keep. Now we're going to give you new money to play with and a brand new deck of cards all shuffled and cut. This time you're going to bet that money, starting on the bottom line with $200 and 3 cards. When you move up to the second level, another $200 of betting money and again 3 more cards. Minimum bet's $50, except when you get to that top card, the big bet. There you must bet at least half the money. Good luck. Really tear it up now.
Oh, thank you.
Here's $200. And your first of 2 base cards, if you need them, is a 10. You want to play that or change it?
I'll play it.
You'll play it. I often think of that as kind of a borderline card. You're going to try it, huh, Renee?
I'll go $100 that it's lower, Jim.
$100 right away on a borderline card. $100 lower than a 10. No, it's a jack. Ooh. Down to 100, but you've got a little better card, a jack. What's your bet here?
Okay, I'll go $100 lower.
$100 lower. This time, $100 lower than a jack.
Yeah.
That's better, a 5. Now you got $200 on the 5.
Okay. I'll go $150 higher.
Big better there, Renee. $150 higher than a 5. It is a 9. You did it. $350 and the 9, which we move up and add the other $200 of betting money. Renee, you've got $550 now and a 9.
I'm not nuts about the 9. I think I'm just going to bet $100 that it's lower.
Lower.
Mm-hmm.
$100 lower than a 9. No, it's a queen.
Well,
you almost said 50. I wish you had, Renee. You've got $450 now and a queen.
Okay, and the queen, I'll go $300 lower.
Big bet now. $300 lower than a queen. No, it's an ace. Now you get a great card. You've only got $150 to bet with.
I better bet it all higher.
Had to go with it all.
I mean lower.
Lower. Did you say higher, Renee?
Yes.
I wouldn't hold you to that. $150 lower than an ace. It's a 2, very much lower. Now the cards are falling. $300. You've got to bet at least $150, but you've got a great card.
Yeah.
You can bet more.
I'll bet it all higher.
All right. $300 bet. You'll have nothing or $600 if this is higher than a 2, and it is just a little higher. $600. You do inch up there, don't you? Come on over, Renee. You inch up there little by little.
That was close. That was real close.
Well, you've now inched up to $4,200. That's not bad.
That's terrific.
And we'll meet a new challenger right after this commercial break. Please watch. Surprise there at the beginning. You know, you get those aces and twos earlier. Renee, let's meet a new challenger, and Janice, if you will, load in the cards. Here's our next player on Card Charge. Hello, Gay Rod. Hi, Gay.
How are you?
Hi, nice to meet you. I'm fine, and how about you?
I'm just fine.
And tell us something about yourself.
I'm from Houston, Texas.
I would have guessed, Gay.
And I'm married, and I have two children, and I sell real estate, and then when I don't have that much to do, we go on the ranch on the weekend.
Oh, you have a ranch, too? A Texan with a ranch? I didn't know
That's
they really
right.
did those things.
That's right, we do.
Good. Well, nice to have you here with us.
Thank you.
Good luck in the match.
Thank you.
You'll be playing the lower cards, the blue cards. Renee, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red cards. We'll start with a question to you, Renee. We took a confidential poll. Well, whenever they say that, I get worried what's coming next. We took a confidential poll of 100 married women and asked them, if a very attractive man asked you to have a one-night affair and you knew that your husband would never find out, would you do it? How many women said they, yes? How many women said yes, they would have a one-night affair?
Well, Jim, I think an awful lot of them would think about it under circumstances like that. But I'm thinking that not very many would actually do it. I'd say 20.
You say 20?
Mm-hmm.
She says 20 out of 100. If they could get away with it, would have a one-night affair with a very attractive man, Gay. Higher or lower?
They're saying higher. I'll go a little higher. I wouldn't, but I think it's higher.
Okay. You covered all the bases on that,
right.
Gay. The actual number of women who would have a one-night affair if they knew their husband would never find out is 20. Right on the button, Renee.
Oh,
right smack on the button. Your base card, Renee, is an 8. They're lying, somebody in the audience said.
I don't like the 8, Jim. I'd like to change it, please.
And it becomes a big
oh,
ace.
Holy.
Could have used that over there a little earlier.
I like that one. I'll go lower, please.
Lower than an ace. It is a 10.
I'll go one more time and go lower.
Lower than a 10. It is a 5. Two cards to risk now.
Okay. Try it one more time and go higher.
Higher than a 5. No, it's a 2. Someone in the audience said freeze, and that time you should have. You lost all three of them. Gay plays a 7. Can't change it, Gay. What's this card?
We'll have to go with the odds and go higher.
Higher than a 7. It is a 10. It is higher.
Well, I have a free card. I'm going to go lower.
You're going to go for it. Lower than a 10. Oh, it's an 8. Ooh, and you lose both of those cards. Neither player could advance. Janice will fill in the spaces. Gay, the question goes to you this time. We polled 100 newlywed men and asked them, did your bride burn the very first meal she ever cooked for you? How many men said yes?
Mine would, I know. Probably about 75.
75. What did you cook that you burned the first time?
First bad mistake, I cooked shrimp with the shell on.
Okay. She says 75 say, yeah, they burned the first meal they ever cooked. Higher or lower?
I'm going to go lower, Jim.
You say lower.
Yeah.
The actual number of newlywed men whose bride burned the very first meal is 2. It's much lower, Renee. Well, you see, they just didn't try shrimp, Gay. That's the whole thing. Renee, we're looking at an ace.
Yeah, I like that ace, and I'll go lower, please.
Lower than an ace. It is a 9.
I'll go one more and go lower.
Lower than a 9? No, it's a queen. I think you knew you were taking a risk on that card, Gay. Play off the 7 and call this.
I know that 7's terrible, but I'm going to go higher again.
Higher again. No, it's not higher. It's a 6. Again, no advance. Next question to you, Renee.
Okay.
We asked 100 waitresses, have you ever eaten a customer's leftovers? How many waitresses admitted they had?
I've been a waitress before, and I've done it.
Oh, you have done it?
Well, you know, toward the edge of the steak or something.
Oh, of course, yes.
That's kind of a middle-of-the-road question. I'm going to say 45.
You 45. You say that's a middle-of-the-road question. What do waitresses do that's worse than that, Renee? Gay, higher or lower than 45 say they've eaten a customer's leftovers?
I think they get meals, so I'm going to say a little lower.
You're going to say lower. All right. The actual number of hungry waitresses who have eaten a customer's leftovers is 29. It's lower. Gay.
I do not want seven.
Gay, you would have been a lot better off if you hadn't cooked the shrimp. And Renee, you would have better off if you didn't eat the food. Now you can get rid of that seven.
I do want to get rid of it.
Okay. Three. Good change.
I'd like to go higher, please.
Higher than a three. It is a jack.
I'd like to go lower, please.
Lower than a jack. Yes, it's a six now. What are you going to do, Gay?
I'm going to go higher.
You're going to go higher than a six.
Oh.
No, it's a two. And you lost all three of them again. Renee, that's a break for you. Call this card.
Lower, please.
Lower than an ace. No, it's another ace. With all of that busting, it puts us in a most interesting situation because both players need four cards. That's right. Sudden death? Someone's going to have to turn over four straight cards. This will decide it. Gay. We asked 100 men in California, is crying a sign of weakness in a man? How many men said yes, crying is a sign of weakness?
Probably about 72.
72 men, she says. Higher or lower, Renee?
It is, and I'm going to say lower.
You say lower. I'll find out the answer as you do. Of being someone, I cry at supermarket openings, so what do I know? The actual number of men who said crying is a sign of weakness in a man is 16. Very much lower, Renee. All right, Renee. You've got a good card there, the ace side. I'm sure you wouldn't want to change it, but you would have to turn over all four of these cards to win, or Gay wins the game. However, you can force Gay to play off the three, again a good card, but she would have to turn over four cards, or the game is yours. Your decision, Renee, do you want to play it with your four cards or force Gay to play it with her four?
I don't trust myself. I'm going to pass it to Gay.
Thanks.
Okay, Gay. I think you knew you were going to get
it.
Start calling Gay. One mistake in the first game of the match belongs to Renee.
Higher.
Higher than a three. It is a king and a good card.
Lower.
Lower than a king. It is a 10. You're halfway there.
Lower.
Lower than a 10. No, it's an ace. Couldn't do it. Renee wins the first game of the match and $100. Oh, those cards were tough for you, ladies. Maybe you make a comeback game. We'll find out if she can right after we take time out for this. You know, I must say, Gay, we were talking about it there, that you had those three cards in the six. I thought you were going to freeze on that.
I should have.
Yeah, you would have gone.
As it turns out.
Yeah, you would have gone into sudden death just needing that one card where Renee needed four.
It could have been better.
Yeah, you got to watch the strategy. It's very important in this game.
Was.
So, Renee leads 1-0. And Janice, if you will, load in the cards for the next game. Same two decks of cards. Renee, we asked 100 men, if there were a pill which would make you tell the complete truth about everything. You didn't think that was going to be the question, did you? No. Would you be willing to take it? How many men said they'd be willing to take this truth pill?
Oh, dear, I can't imagine very many have wanted to do that. I'm going to go... No, I'm going to go seven.
Seven. She says seven men would be willing to take this truth pill.
I think lower than seven.
You say lower than that. The actual number of men who would be willing to take a pill that makes you tell the complete truth about everything is 40. It's not lower. Wow, Renee.
That is a surprise.
I think they were lying. Renee, we'll look at your base card. It is a nine.
I don't like it.
Don't like it. The next one is a four.
That's much better. I like that better. And I'll go higher, Jim.
Higher than a four. It is a jack.
Great. I'll go lower.
Lower than a jack. A six.
I'm going to freeze.
You'll freeze it right there, needing two cards for the win. Gay, the question to you. We pulled 100 married women across the country and asked them, if you could spend every hour of every day with your husband, would you really want to? How many women said they would want to spend every hour of every day with their husband?
Very few, I think. I'd say about 17.
17 would want to spend every hour of every day, Renee. Higher or lower?
I'm going to go a little bit higher.
You say higher?
Just a little.
The actual number of married women who would want to spend every hour of every day with their husband is 12. It's not higher. Renee. Yes. Renee, you're looking at a 6 here, and you want to change. No, excuse me, Gay, you're going to look at your base card. You have a 9.
I'd like to change it, please.
Here's the next card, and it is a 3.
That's a good card. I'd like to go higher, Jim.
Higher than a 3. Oh, no, it's a 2. There is a break for Renee, who's going to get a free chance to play off this 6.
Yay. I'll go higher, please.
Higher than a 6. It's another 6. It's not higher. We'll fill in the spaces, and we'll be right back to this exciting match right after we take timeout for this. Join us next time on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
A representative of the studio audience will receive a Botany 500 sports coat for the gentlemen. Suede elbow patches accent the Chase sports coat with a rich, rustic look of fall. Created with fine American craftsmanship, furnished by Botany 500. And some of our contestants will receive from Gallery of Homes a book on home improvements. Gallery of Homes brokers. If you're selling or buying a home, you'll find they do their homework. And Cool Ray, fashionable sunglasses that win admiring stares while protecting from annoying glare. 86 eye-catching styles. See what you're missing with Cool Ray, polarized sunglasses. And Whammo, turn off the heat and turn on slip and slide. 25 feet of cool, slippery, sliding water fun from Whammo. And Eureka's new ESP, extra suction power vacuum. 50% more power, more beating, brushing, and cleaning action. 6-way height adjustment Eureka. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.